see you again. The team are now ready to start development on some new upgrades. You can review these from within the laptop. I'll speak to you later, okay?
Oh my god, that was the best day he has ever said to me, like... Cheers, mate. Good edit that and make it funny, but that was pretty much, I think, the best intro I've ever done to an FNJ 16 episode. I bet I've put my best. But here we are for this episode. We're here in Austria for the Austrian Grand Prix. We're still the second fastest car, but still got a lot of development to do on this car. So, yeah, got a lot of work to do. Let's get to practice and get some resource points. So, oriented track optimization test. We're just trying to set some purple ones. This is probably my favorite section, the Austrian Grand Prix, going very, very fast through that snake section. That's a cane there, but going through the final corners, as you can see, we get a bit of a green there, and another one, pretty disappointed. But on the DRS, we get that purple, and probably that is going to be enough to get the purple result on the track acclimatization test. So pretty good way to start off the weekend. Next up, of course, you may already know, is it tire management test, and it was time for Inter. So I've done a tire management test on the Inters on light rain conditions, and we were really doing well. I gotta say, so we got quite a lot of purples already, as you can see there, crossing the line, another purple, and yeah, it really did go well. I gotta say, it just felt pretty comfortable, pretty comfy onto that car with that set of Inters. I didn't have any head traction, and I really felt like the pace was there, and also the tires were really, really good, and we got the purple result there. But next up, we had the qualifying pace test, which is probably the hardest test you could go on for. But right now, already through the first sector, you can see that through the first sector we're like extremely fast. We're like something like 4 tenths faster than the target lap time. But now, through this corner, we just lost a hell of a lot of time. And we already see we lost something like 3 tenths of that corner. So you really see like how much time we lost there. But at the end of the day, at the end of the first lap, we made it. And yeah, we just got the green one, and I was pretty happy about that. Next up was pole position, target lap time. It was like 5 tenths faster. I thought I could do it. I really thought I could do it. And but once again, first sector faster than the target lap time, which is always a good sign of things to see. But once again, lost time on that corner. Not that matters last time, but we still lost time, and that probably held us up to get another green on this test. We couldn't get the purple one, and actually we end the practice session with the green, with a completed test, and pretty much we have perfect on the track acclimatization test, perfect on the time management test, two really, really good set tests to start off the weekend. But also pretty good on the qualifying pace test. Let's don't be arrogant. Let's just say that it is a good test. We completed that one, and I gotta say I'm very, very happy for that Friday test. And yeah, next up, gonna make those tests use into qualifying. Make use of those tests into qualifying, and yeah, pretty much hope we can do very well in the qualifying, and so we get another pole position for the Renault Career Mode in this 2016 game. Straight off onto qualifying. Ricciardi starting P7 behind Jenson Button. Ricciardi is on provisional pole position at the moment. Going now around the last corner to start my final and best lap on this qualifying session. We have to push the cars once we can, because we're in P7, we don't really want to be in that position. We're also going to get a bit of a slipstream there from Nico Rosberg. That's very, very helpful. Fastest onto the first sector, 1 tenth faster. We get that corner nicely right here. I think that's the first time I've just cleansed that corner very, very nicely. Very, very happy to see that thing happening right here. Turning perfectly on that corner. Ah, just a bit of an understeer, there on that corner. But now through probably my favorite section of the circuit, go through this corner with fifth gear, go back down to fifth gear after going up to sixth, And now through the final corners, as you can see, through the final corner down to fourth gear. Now accelerate as fast as you can. We're 5 tenths faster than our last lap, and I believe we're in P3. So yeah, P3 for the race. Let's just get in the race and hope we can do well, guys.
What a beautiful backdrop to a motor race. We're here in the Styrian Mountains, of course, and they've watched over some cracking races throughout the history of this Grand Prix. Controversy, of course, think back to 2002, but also great joy. Do you remember Niki Lauda's historic home victory in 1984? The Red Bull Ring then, 700 metres above sea level. This tough circuit may only have 9 corners, but they're fast and they're bumpy. It's a true test for any racing driver. We have 2 DRS zones, and watch out for overtakes into turn 2 as the uphill entry helps those trying to be the last of the late breakers steam up the inside. A tough race in store then for our drivers today. So tell me, Anthony Davidson, what will you be looking out for as the cars make their way down into turn 1?
Well, first of all, let's hope that everyone's well behaved and we can have a nice incident-free start. That initial release is going to be the most interesting thing. The clean side of the grid will be better rubbered in, so keep an eye out for cars over there potentially making their way through.
Right, let's be patient going into turn 1. We want to be in a good position for the rest of the race. Good luck.
So, on the grid now for the Austrian Grand Prix, starting from P3, as I've already told you, the end of the qualifying session. We couldn't beat the Red Bulls. But I think it was a very, very good lap. It was very fast. Like, the standards of this car are not to beat the Red Bulls. Red Bull still has the fastest car. But we're going to see in race pace who's the fastest, apparently. Race strategy seems pretty legit to me. I'm going to make a bit of a question here. Could we enter for a set of super subs on the last stint? I don't know. We'll see about that. But 5 lights. And it's lights. I don't know where we go for the Austrian Grand Prix. We get off to a very, very good start. Very clean start. No wheel spin, no nothing. Pretty much nothing happened into turn 1. We get the stop and run just a little bit wide. I don't know if that was an illegal overtake. You're going to tell me in the comments below. But we're into P2 already from the start. We couldn't get into P1. Because the run from third position to the turn 1 is just really small enough to overtake 2 cars into turn 1, so I think that's the best we could do. And now going down the inside probably of Daniel Ricciardo, we just quietly couldn't make the move stick there. I just oh my god, safety car.
Safety car has been deployed. Watch your delta.
Safety car.
Positive as we catch the pack. We think there's a viable strategy change available to
safety
us.
Car is in
to the current plan or try
on lap 1. That clearly changes the plan for strategy. We're going in for a set of soft tires. Is it a gamble? Is it gonna work? You know, those tires are gonna work like for 4 laps, so I think there is no need to hold on to those tires. They have no life. And we're going in for a set of softs. We're going in for a set of softs. I think we're gonna go. We're gonna get away. We're not gonna get away with any less pit stops, but I think like when the others are gonna do pit stops for the ultra soft tires, I'm gonna be ahead of them, so I think that's the best we could do. And currently I think I crossed the line ahead of NASA. I crossed the line ahead. I crossed the line of the pit stops ahead of NASA. Anyways, we're gonna give that one to NASA, no worries about that. But lap 1 safety car, but now lap 4 we go. Safety car is... Is that Ricciardo who's out of the race? But no, it's Kevin Magnussen. Kevin Magnussen, once again, unlucky. He's going to retire from the Austrian Grand Prix as we get down himself. Felipe Nasr, very, very good to see that, already making inroads on those cars. Bottas tries to go around the outside of Perez. Go around the outside of Bottas. Down the inside of Perez. But we've been tangled up by Bottas. And we're out of the race. We are out of the Austrian Grand Prix, and I just can't believe it. We go straight past Bottas. They try to change the line onto Perez. I didn't completely change lines, as you can see right here. Wait a bit, I'm go. I want to go in the cockpit. Wait a bit, guys. Wait a bit. I want to go. Yeah, on board with Bottas. He's right behind me, and I believe, like, yeah, I thought that would be just a little bit clear of Bottas, and we wouldn't tangle up with each other. So, probably my mistake. Yeah, it's probably my mistake, I gotta say, because it seems like I tend to change lines to overtake Perez, in the idea of that Bottas would be light up my ass, pretty much. And he was very, very close to my back, and yeah, we retired from the Austrian Grand Prix after having a great strategy call that could easily give us the win.
A great win then for the Red Bull team today.
We retired and didn't get any points at all.
Anthony,
not the best start to the episode, I gotta say.
We were looking at an entirely different race before the safety car came out.
Yeah, you really look. That happened because of the safety car. If I would stay in and be just behind Ricciardo, that thing would have happened. I was in a rush, trying to overtake as many cars as I could. I was like, I need to hurry, I need to pass those cars. They're pretty slow. We need to catch up with the Red Bulls again. Whilst my strategy would work perfectly, even if I would be patient. But apparently, that's it. For the Austrian Grand Prix, we lost many points. Next stop, I think it's Silverstone. We're still first in the driver standing, so we should be pretty happy about that. Construct standings, we lost P1 because both of our cars retired. That's pretty unlucky once again. But yeah, let's go into Silverstone. Hope we can do it. We have better luck there. So here on practice for Silverstone, as you can see, perfect track optimization test, perfect time management test, and we've completed the qualifying pace test. So, pretty good way to start off the next race we're gonna do on this episode. So, yeah, I don't think that there is any better way. Well, perfect qualifying pace test would be perfect, but we just couldn't do it. But now, on to qualifying we go. Let's hope for a better qualifying session. In Austria, it wasn't that bad. We started from P3. To be true, I would be very happy with third position also here in Silverstone, but we're gonna try for something a little bit more. We slowed down here to let the car through. So yeah, let's try accelerate right now and start off our lap. So yeah, we started off our lap already faster now through the first corner with 8 gear. You have to take it. Rating on the 100 meter boards. Shift down to third gear. I'm shifting down to the second gear. As the game might say third, but I'm going down to the second gear. But first sector, we are fastest on the first sector by 1/10. Over Max Verstappen and 3/10 over our last personal best lap, but we are fastest off the track onto the first sector. But now going through the old start finish straight now through the old first corner, we already have an improvement of almost 1 second right here. We seem to fly on that fast lap going out through don't even remember the name of those corners, I'm sorry about that. We'll try and remember that next time. But now through second sector, we are fastest on the track with 4/10, by 4/10 fastest on the track, and 1.2 faster than our previous lap. That's absolutely insane how fast we're going right now. Onto the last sector we are now, onto the last sequence of corners. Not a lot of corners remaining, probably one last corner. This is the last corner. Across the line, it is going to be, and it's pole position for the English Grand Prix of the Great Britain Grand Prix. I don't even know the British Grand Prix. I'm sorry about that, but pole position for the British Grand Prix.
All set then for the race tomorrow. But before we go, let's quickly remind ourselves of our top three, who are a Renault, Ricciardo, and Max Verstappen. It's time to leave for now, but we'll be back tomorrow when the Grand Prix itself gets underway.
Absolutely amazing. We got a win here in... We got a win. Yeah, still not a win, but yeah, I'm still imagining of this win. So let's get into the race and hope I can get the win from pole position.
We're right back where it all began. The very first World Championship Grand Prix was held here at Silverstone in 1950, with Giuseppe Farina taking the top step of an all-Alfa Romeo podium. He earned 9 championship points that day on his way to the inaugural title. His winning total at the season's end, just 30 points. My, how times have changed. So let's see who can reach the top step of the modern podium today. Straddling the border of Northamptonshire and Buckinghamshire, the 18 corners of the Silverstone circuit form the 3.6-mile beating heart of Formula One. It's been reinvented over the years, with Turn 1 now the fast right-hander of Abbey, along with 2 DRS zones on the Wellington and Hanger Straits respectively. But the magic of racing is as strong here as it's ever been. I'm joined again today by none other than Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, obviously there's a lot of development work that goes on with these cars between the races. You've been both a test driver and a race driver. What differences are there in the way you approach those roles?
Interesting question, Crofty. They're 2 very different mindsets. I mean, when I tested for BAR, we had full in-season testing where, per driver, you'd cover up to 15,000 kilometres per season. And in that role, it was more about working for the team, trying to help them improve the car and drive as systematically as you could, so that that data could be analysed in the most consistent way. When you're lining up on the grid for a race, however, your frame of mind's all about what you can get out of the situation on that day, and the car's the tool to help you achieve what you want. You still want to focus on setup, of course, but it's more about the here and now, getting yourself as far up the field as possible, and less about development work for the future.
Okay, remember to protect the inside on the run down to turn 1. Make yourself as wide as possible, robust, but fair.
So, on the grid, off the British Grand Prix, we're on pole position. That was probably the most amazing lap I've ever done in my life. It was a stunning lap, and I don't really have any words to describe it, but it seems very, very okay to me. I'm going to be on softs, then on mediums, and then on hards, so that's pretty much it. Like, pretty easy strategy. I hope we're gonna get off to a good start and not lose the leads. But 1 light, 2 lights, 3 lights, 4 lights, and it's 5 lights, and it's time to go on with the British Grand Prix. I've started off with got up to a decent start. We didn't lose position. Verstappen couldn't get me into turn 1, and from now on, it's easy peasy, lemon squeezy. We just got to open a gap, build a gap from the cars behind. It's all gonna be done. Believe me or not, we've got to do it. I think now, by being on the lead, we could seriously do some damage to those guys right now if we can open the gap. But I see the cross on the mini pop, as you saw. That's the cross! Verstappen! Got taken out by the Mercedes, and also now on board with Daniel Ricciardo. Ricciardo! It's not Hamilton's fault, it's Ricciardo's fault. He's taken out himself, both himself and Max Verstappen, so the 2 Red Bulls have crossed out each other. That's where we race over the 2 Red Bulls, like, really unlucky for the 2 Red Bulls. My teammate gets advantage out of that. He is now probably up into P3, but the 2 Red Bulls are out of this race. Not out of this race, are out of they don't have any chances to win this race now. Very, very unlucky for Verstappen. Very bad driving for Daniel, I can only say. But now they're in the last 2 positions, so apparently because of that, yes, I don't know if it is because of that, but we got a safety car out of something, and we're gonna change a bit of strategy. We're gonna enter the pit stops right over here on this lap 3, and don't even know, was it a strategy change? Was I meant to be on lap later? I don't even know. But yeah, we're doing a pit stop right now. We're gonna enter for a set of mediums, and I think the guys who really didn't enter the pit stops on this lap, they're going to have a huge disadvantage against us, because we pitted earlier, they're going to be stuck behind the safety car, and when they pit, we're just going to be miles ahead of them. So that also includes my teammate once again, who That's a terrible strategy, but we're provisionally in P1, but let's see where we're going to exit. Behind which car we're going to exit. Now Grosjean side by side with me. Ah, come on. I thought I could be ahead of Grosjean right here, but just couldn't, just for a little bit. Just some tenths of a second. Lap 6, the safety car is back into the pit stops and we are back on racing. Yeah, green flag it is. We're already up to P2 after some drivers have pitted. With some, a huge amount of drivers have pitted, but yeah, we're in P2 behind Sergio Perez. We have a viable strategy. Let's see that. No, come on, man. I'm going to pit on lap 9. It's just bullcrap. That's yeah, behind Perez. Let's try and overtake him and get back into the lead of this race. Lap 7. On to Ultra 1. He's a lot. He's pretty slow. He just stops our rhythm, stops our pace. We go side by side through that corner. Absolutely insane. Imagine if you would have held that. You would have held that. If he had good tires, he would have held up for easily. And we have an amazing battle with Sergio Perez. But we got back into P1. And yeah, good to control the pace now of the race. Lap 9, we're entering the pits for the set of hard tires. For set of medium tires, I'm sorry. And yeah, it's going to be a set of mediums now. And let's pretty much hope it's going to be a good pit stop, because Sebastian Vettel is stuck behind us and he could easily overtake us if Renner does make a mistake onto the pit stop. So, it's so for a fast pit stop. It is a fast pit stop today, but the fuckers have... It happened again. Vettel, provisionally in P1 at the moment, is just... I don't know, like... Hamilton also is in P1 at the moment. Brilliant, isn't it? It actually is brilliant, because he's gonna hold up. He's gonna hold up Vettel. So, I'm gonna take advantage of that. Vettel side by side with Hamilton. Oh, they made contact with their wheels. Wheel to wheel action. I'm gonna try and overtake Lewis Hamilton now. Oh, I'm gonna stuck behind him. Some good exits through those corners. Is it gonna be possible with the help of DRS? Now we're gonna make a dive on Lewis Hamilton. Oh no, come on. Now he just backs off there. Around the outside, he squeezes off the circuit. But in terms of the inside line, we make the move sick up into P2. Next stop, Sebastian Vettel. For the lead of this race once again. It's pretty hard to come in terms with Vettel. He seems to get away from me. And that's not really a good sign of things to see, because we seem to not have pace on our set of mediums. And also my teammate has overtaken me. I just let him through right here because I don't really want to hold him up. And You just know the story. This is how I am, like, this is how I'm driving. I don't really want to hold up my teammate. If he's faster than me, I'm letting him through. If he's as fast as me, then we're gonna have a battle, but now that he's faster than me, I'm going to let him through and let him build his pace. But he's entering the pit stops also, the same lap as Vettel, and I'm gonna stay one more lap out for the overcut. And then we're gonna go in for a set of hards to finish the race. So it's gonna be pretty close to see what is gonna happen. Yeah, I mean the next lap, Jeff. But anyways, lap 16. As I've already told you, we're entering the pit stops for that set of hard tires once again. I see a Ferrari behind me. This time it's Kimi Raikkonen. Like Renault, please this time do not let me, exit the pit stops behind Raikkonen, please. I'm like, please, come on. Oh my god, you must be joking. This is enough, like, that's enough. That's enough. I'm leaving Renault next season. I want to be in the top team. Once again, they let Raikkonen ahead of me. Also, forgot to mention that we're actually on a set of mediums. I think I can make it till the end. Actually 10 laps remaining, and I think we can make it on a set of medium tires. Safety car. Safety car is out. Oh my god, do we pass it? That's what I tried to. Anyways, we had a bit of a collision there with the safety car. If that happened in Andersteer, let's just hashtag Andersteer, but we made contact with the safety car, which was pretty strange to see. But now it's game on. Sebastian Vettel leading the race, me in second place. We gotta do this, guys. We gotta fight for that victory. 5 laps remaining on this British Grand Prix. Raikkonen behind me, Vettel ahead of me. I've been sandwiched from the two Ferraris, but we don't have a lot of time to make that move to stick. We gotta make it if we want to win this race. Now onto the old turn one. We're gonna go and try to make Sebastian Vettel. We didn't go side by side. We got him into P1 already. Greatly done there by me. But now it's not gonna be very easy to hold on ahead of Vettel, because he's probably going to have DRS on this lap, on this straight, the back straight for the British Grand Prix. And let's see what he has to say about my move. Lap 26, the last lap. Sebastian Vettel is going to try and get down inside. He makes the move. Raikkonen also tries to go down inside. He just quietly can't. Side by side with me, Raikkonen has been taken out. We go side by side with Sebastian Vettel. We hold it on. And I believe that's going to be game over. We stayed ahead of Vettel. We fought for that win. Great win after a disappointing result in Austria. Get in, guys. Another win. Get in. What a wonderful race! What a wonderful race full of fights. This race pretty much had everything. I had a bit of a dominant like pace. Then the safety car came in. It really fluffed everything, like the drivers. Like, we saw Vettel fighting for the win. We saw even Perez fighting for that win, and we now see him on the podium. Like, it was an amazing race. I don't have any words to describe it. What a race that was. Sergio Perez from P12 up into P3. Sebastian from P11 up into P2. Fernando Alonso from P8 up into P4. Massa from P15 to P6. Like, that really describes the race. The two Toros from last on the grid end up in P10 and 9, like, absolutely amazing race. Probably one of the most exciting races I've ever driven at. And yeah, driver standings. This time we extended our lead from Max Verstappen. 19 points it is this time. Lewis Hamilton actually passed Kimi Raikkonen the driver standings, and my teammate lost another position. This time for Valtteri Bottas. He's just doing worse and worse and worse, instead of better and better, while the car is getting better. The driver standings, it's pretty much the same. 28 points behind Red Bull. I really gotta say, like, I think we can beat them. I think we can beat them till the end of the season as the car gets better. But yeah, until then, I'm gonna see you next time, guys. If you enjoyed that video, smash the like button. If you haven't subscribed, really subscribe. Follow me on Twitter and on Instagram. Ask me anything, ask a fan. But yeah, until the next video, I'll see you next time, guys. Goodbye. We'll be right back.
Hi. It's good news. You certainly seem to be attracting some attention. These papers arrived on my desk this morning. How do you feel about new surroundings?
Thank you.